Have you been struggling to set up your MIDI controller for live looping in Logic Pro 10? Let me help you by showing you three ways to gain control of your session. The live loops grid has become a great tool to trigger and record loops. However, sometimes it's hard to figure out all the correct settings to make a live looping session work. Watch this video until the end and let me teach you how to use smart controls to perform with remix effects, how to navigate through your session using key commands, and how to trigger individual cells with custom controller assignments. If you are new to my channel, ahoy! I'm SWONIC. I create performance and tutorial videos. If you're into finger drumming, live looping, and electronic dance rock music, please consider subscribing. Okay, let's create a new project with the live loops template. I'll add the champion chords layers loop and the drum synth instrument so we can create some music too. What we'll be using today is a MIDI controller with a fader. You can use one with a knob as well, and four buttons. I'll also use a MIDI keyboard. Right here I have a Roly Lightback block with a custom dynamic controls mode, but you can use any MIDI controller with faders, knobs and buttons. The first thing I want to show you is how to use smart controls for your performance. It's important to know that smart controls let you only control the parameters of the currently selected track. So what you can see here are the smart controls for the heavy kick track in the main window. Since we want to control the remix effects on the stereo output, we need to show it in the main window. We can select the output track now, and we will see the smart controls for the remix effects. Before adding your own controls, it always makes sense to check the default mappings. But to avoid errors in your session, I recommend going to the parameter mappings and delete all patch mappings. Doing this on all tracks will prevent you from accidentally changing any settings when the wrong track is selected, because once you've assigned a hardware control to a smart control, it will always be active. I'll show you exactly what I mean shortly. Let's undo this and instead create a first controller assignment. Choose the smart control you want to assign, press the Learn button here, and then move the control on your controller. So if we go back to our kick track, you will see that I'm controlling the pitch now with the same fader. So to prevent this, we will delete the patch mappings. Let's go back to the stereo output. The control I want to create is a filter sweep with the remix effects. Pressing on the user interface with the cursor here does a couple of things simultaneously. So what's happening is, when you press this XYZ pad, actually first the filter gets activated, and then if you start moving, you're changing the frequency for resonance and cutoff. We will need to map all three of these parameters to one single hardware control if we want to use our fader to do the same thing. Let's move this a little up and select the smart control we want to assign. Then we can press the Learn Parameter Mapping button and press here. To add more parameters to the same smart control, we need to choose Add Mapping here. Choose this one, hit Learn again, and voila, we have cutoff and on-off now. Let's do this once again. Add Mapping, Learn, and Resonance showed up. You can see it's turning on and off the filter at 50% and not already when I touch it. So we need to go to the filter on-off and change the scaling settings. Let's deactivate stepped and look at this curve. You can see at 50% it goes from off to on. So let's just make this straight and move the on completely to the left so that already at value 1 we move from off to on. Let's try this. Perfect. Now let's make an adjustment to the cutoff setting as well. You might have noticed that the filter changes from low pass to high pass at 50%. The default range of the filter is from -1 to +1. We will limit the range maximum to 0. Finally, let's invert the range of the resonance to make the sweep end a little smoother. Let's start the loop and test the fader. Perfect. Next, we will look at how to navigate through a session with key commands. Actually, you don't even need a controller to do that. By default, the arrow keys on your keyboard will allow you to select cells and change tracks. You can hit Option R to start and end recording of a selected cell. You can trigger cells with the return key. That way, you can easily start and stop playback. And with the delete key, you can also delete cells. Mapping these commands to buttons on your MIDI controller is really easy. Open the key commands window from the menu, or press Option K. The list you get here shows you all the key commands available in Logic Pro. Sometimes it can be difficult to find what you're looking for. But if you know the command already, you can get to it by pressing the corresponding keys. Like for example, Option R. Or if you know its name, you can use the search field in the top right corner. Also, you can browse through the different categories to see if you can find what you're looking for. Let's map two buttons on our controller to change the selected track. The commands I want to use are select next upper cell and select next lower cell. To assign this command, simply select it in the browser, press learn new assignment, and press the corresponding button on your controller. Let's do this for the other command as well. Learn new assignment, up. Okay, let's see if it works. Perfect. Basically, all the commands you can find in the live loops category may be useful when creating a live looping setup. To show you my favorite key commands for live looping, I created this list. The final thing I want to show you is how to make custom controller assignments. Open the controller assignments window from the menu or by pressing Option Shift K. After you open it, make sure you are in expert view. You can already see the three assignments we did today. You might also see more controls in your window if you have some control surfaces installed. Be careful when editing or deleting things if you don't exactly know what you're doing. You might mess up the behavior of your installed control surfaces. Let's start by renaming the controls we already created. This first one is the smart control number 1 we assigned in the very beginning to our fader. Let's name it filter sweep. The other two are the buttons to switch between tracks. If you press a button on your controller, the corresponding assignment will be selected automatically. Let's name this one track up and the other one track down. Now I want to show you something really powerful. By activating learn mode, you can pretty much get control of any Logic Pro parameter there is. So let's try to create a control for triggering the first cell in the live loops grid. Let me mute the stereo output first, then I'll activate learn mode. You can see it creates a new assignment. Then I'll trigger the cell and hit the button on my controller. Now let's end learn mode. Sometimes the learn mode doesn't get the assignments right. So let's check what kind of assignment we have created here. We want to trigger a cell, so that's in the class channel script, that's right. But we want to choose the cell by its index. The first cell has the index 1 and the parameter is live loop cell column 1. To get the numbers right, you have to know that the live loops grid is divided into columns and rows. The column is shown in the parameter name and the channel strip index shows the number of the row. So the first cell has index 1 in column 1. Let's call it trigger cell 1 1, and check out if it works. Trigger. Stop. Perfect. It's important to choose index here because if you have fader bank or anything else, the controls won't work in all windows. Now let's create another control to trigger cell 1 2. Activate learn mode. Trigger the cell. Press the control. Deactivate learn mode. And check what it says here. Fader bank. We need index. And actually, it should be the second row in column 1. Let's name it trigger cell 1 2 and check it out. Boom. Now it's time to see if we can create a little performance with the controls we have created. If you want to learn more about live looping with Logic Pro, you'll find my other tutorial videos somewhere around here. Please let me know in the comments if you found those tips useful and what else you'd like me to talk about. Thanks for watching the whole video. Remember to subscribe and hit the like button. I'll be back soon with another video.